one that has triggered literally thousands of fanfics. The one where the line is so long that tickets cost $500. And those are the cheap ones. The history teachers love it because it teaches history in a fun way. Is everything it says truly accurate, though? Turns out, no. Not everything in Hamilton actually happened to Alexander Hamilton, or it didn't happen the way the musical says. Hamilton was based off the book Alexander Hamilton by Ron Chernow, and it got a lot of things right. Almost everything right, in fact. Unfortunately, that's almost everything, not everything. The almost is the basis of this talk and what I investigated. A brief summary for those who have never heard of this strange Hamilton I speak of. Hamilton is a hit Broadway musical, making its debut February 2015. It features the first Secretary of the Treasury, Alexander Hamilton, starting with his childhood in the Caribbean and ending with his death in a duel with Burr. The first act mainly features the American Revolution, and the second act his political career. So, how is this going to work? I'll compare each major section in Hamilton's life to what the musical says about it, simple enough, right? After his unhappy, mostly accurate on the part of the musical childhood in the Caribbean, Hamilton got his education and signed on to Washington staff, starring probably the most accurate section in the musical. For example, in Right Hand Man, Hamilton talks about stealing a British cannon. This is what actually happened. Hamilton and a few others stole a British cannon and fired back at the British. Still, the British win the battle, leading to, in both the musical and reality, General Washington yelling, "Are these the men with which I am to defend America?" Another example, in Stay Alive, Charles Lee, a general, makes a disastrous decision on the Battle of Monmouth and is demoted. Lee then insults General Washington, prompting John Lawrence, Hamilton's best friend, to challenge Lee to a duel, with Hamilton as his second. Finally, in the Battle of Yorktown, the main similarity is that they sing a war ballad called "The World Turned Upside Down." These are probably the most accurate songs in Act 1. In 1778, General Washington sent Hamilton with a message to General Horatio Gates, asking for more troops. On the way back, he stayed at General Philip Schuyler's house, just coincidentally during the time he was throwing a ball. This was where he first met the Schuyler sisters, Angelica, Eliza, and Peggy. In the song Helpless, Eliza sees Hamilton and she falls in love. They are introduced by Angelica, who also falls in love but swallows her wings so Eliza can be happy. And 2 weeks later, they get married. There are a lot of inaccuracies in this song. For one, it took Eliza a month to fall in love with Hamilton instead of just a night. It didn't even happen at the ball. It happened 2 years later, in 1780, when Eliza went to visit her aunt in Morristown. General Washington and his men, including Alexander Hamilton, were stationed. They were married in December 1780, and their first child, Phil Hamilton, was born in 1782. So, the war is over. America's free. Hamilton is now working as a lawyer, and because he is who he is writing nonstop. That was kind of characteristic of his. He had one flaw, though. He talked too much. He gave a lot of two-hour speeches, and when he was invited to the Constitutional Convention, he talked for 6 straight hours. He wrote a lot too, writing 51 essays for the Federalists defending the US Constitution in only 6 months. Eventually, Washington made him the first Secretary of the Treasury, where he attempted to totally reform American banking system. But there was one obstacle in the way: Thomas Jefferson, the guy who popularized the tomato in America, among other things. Hamilton and Jefferson fought head-to-head about a lot of issues. They published almost vaguely true articles about each other in the newspapers. Jefferson thought Hamilton would make America a monarchy, while Hamilton thought Jefferson would make America an anarchy. Washington, on a lot of issues, sided with Hamilton, and Jefferson got jealous. Despite this, though, despite Jefferson's rivalry with Hamilton, despite Jefferson's jealousy of Hamilton and almost hatred of Hamilton, despite the fact that he disagreed with pretty much everything Alex said politically, Hamilton still chose Jefferson over his friend Aaron Burr in the election of 1800. He also wrote a lot of articles in the newspaper saying things like, "Burr is too neutral," Burr will make a terrible president. Burr will lead the country into chaos. Finally, when he personally insulted Aaron Burr in the newspaper, Burr had had enough and challenged Hamilton to a duel. The agreement was to meet the next day at Weehawken, New Jersey, at dawn. No one really knows who shot first. Hamilton's seconds said Burr shot first. Burr's seconds said Hamilton shot first. Although most people do say Hamilton shot first. Hamilton aimed for the sky, and Burr shot him in the kidney. With Angelica and Eliza beside him, he died. So what's the point of this? What's the point of writing a 13-page essay and editing it down to a 5-minute speech over one musical? What's the point of reading a 1,000-page book just because the musical was based off of it? What's the point of listening to songs 10 times over just because they might have